Hello everyone. In the last video we have seen how to plot two arrays using a plot command. We have also seen how to enable the grid and how to give the x label, y label, and in addition to that, in this video we have also inserted the title to the plot. Okay, now if we run the program, see what happens. Okay, so as you can see, x label is printed here, y label is printed here, and the title of the plot is distance versus velocity, which is printed above the graph. Okay, say you want to plot two graphs in the same plot. Okay, so how do we do that? For that, let us solve some realistic problem. Let this be time t and this be the velocity v, and let us consider some velocity v1, velocity of another vehicle, say be lin space of 5, 10, 11. In the previous video we have explained what is the syntax of lin space command, so if you haven't watched that, you please watch that video and you can come here. Okay, so let us plot time on x axis and velocity v on y axis. Okay, now using hold on command, we can plot another graph. Okay, so say t comma v1. Okay, so now let us run the program and see what happens. You can see that the program ran well and you have two velocities, that is from 0 to 5, that is b, and 5 to 10, that is v1. Note that the arrays should be of same size, otherwise you cannot plot the graph. So let us see, if you have v equal to 10, say, so if you run the program, you can see that it is throwing an error, vectors must be of same length. Okay, hope you got what I mean. Okay, if you want to plot some attractive graphs, say you need stars, okay, and triangles, so you can see from the syntax, for p dash it is for stars and v dash is for triangles. Now if I run the program again, you can see that the stars and triangles are appearing. So what, one more thing what we can do is add a legend so that anyone who sees the graph can understand which is v and which is v1. Okay, so v is with initial condition, v with initial velocity equal to 0. Okay, and v1, let us copy this and paste it here. V1 with initial velocity 5 meters per second, as you can see from the arrays. Okay, now if I run the program again, what difference do you see? Meanwhile, I request you all to practice at your end so that you become more confident in programming. Okay, so it's taking pretty much time. Now you can observe that this stars are for initial velocity v equal to 0 and this triangles are for initial velocity 5. Okay, these legends give an idea of what are all the things included in the graph. Okay, so in the upcoming videos we will be learning about what is if statement, what is a while statement, and what is a for loop, and how we are going to apply the loops to solve a particular problem. Meanwhile, you practice this problem, and if you have any doubt, let me know in the comment section. Okay, I'll be glad to help you out. meanwhile at your end, what you do is you plot for sine x, you plot a sine x graph, you plot a cos x graph, so that you'll be a bit more confident in programming. Okay, that's all for today. See you guys in the next video. Bye.